गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 48 ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी सॉ ऑर्सट अपैरेटस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ थ्योरी एज वेल एज पार्ट ऑफ प्रैक्टिकल। नाउ विल सी स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज। नाउ व्हाट इज मीन बाय स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज? स्टैंडर्ड मीन्स वी आर कंसिडरिंग स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट। स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज इज डिफाइन एज द चेंज इन एंथैल्पी फॉर अ प्रोसेस। चेंज इन एंथैल्पी फॉर अ प्रोसेस, केमिकल और फिजिकल प्रोसेस। ओके, चेंज इन एंथैल्पी फॉर अ केमिकल और फिजिकल प्रोसेस वेयर इनिशियल एंड फाइनल सब्सटेंस आर इन स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट। इनिशियल स्टेट एंड फाइनल स्टेट ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस आर इन स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट। नाउ व्हाट इज मीन बाय स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट? स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट इज कंसिडर्ड एज एटमोस्फेरिक कंडीशन। ओके, एटमोस्फेयर एंड विच एटमोस्फेरिक कंडीशन वी आर कंसिडरिंग हियर? स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट मीन्स एटमोस्फेयर इज एट अ प्रेशर ऑफ एटमोस्फेयर इज 1 atmosphere एंड 25 degree Celsius। प्रेशर शुड बी 1 atmosphere एंड 25 degree Celsius। इफ द एंथैल्पी चेंज हैपन्स फ्रॉम स्टेट 1 टू स्टेट 2 एंड इनिशियल स्टेट एंड फाइनल स्टेट और ड्यूरिंग ए एंथैल्पी चेंज, प्रेशर इज 1 atmosphere एंड टेम्परेचर इज 25 degree Celsius, देन द चेंज इन एंथैल्पी इज कॉल्ड एज अ स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज। नाउ व्हाट इज मीन बाय 1 atmosphere? 1 atmosphere इज 1.01325 bar। समटाइम्स इट इज टेकन एज एट 1 bar ऑल्सो। ओके, इवन एट 1 bar और 1 atmosphere प्रेशर एंड 25 degree Celsius द एंथैल्पी चेंज इट्स कॉल्ड एज स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज। नाउ एंथैल्पी चेंज इज रिटन एज डेल्टा एच एंड स्टैंडर्ड एंथैल्पी चेंज इज रिटन एज डेल्टा एच नॉट। हियर वी आर यूजिंग नॉट, डेल्टा एच 0 और डेल्टा एच नॉट। एग्जाम्पल, स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट ऑफ अ लिक्विड इज वाटर। स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट ऑफ अ लिक्विड इज वाटर इज अ प्योर लिक्विड एट एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर एंड 25 degree Celsius। 1 atmosphere प्रेशर एंड 25 degree Celsius मीन्स अ स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट ऑफ वॉटर इज अ लिक्विड स्टेट। ओके, नाउ एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन। नाउ व्हाट इज मीन बाय फॉर्मेशन? वी आर राइटिंग एंथैल्पी डेल्टा एच एंड एफ स्टैंड्स फॉर फॉर्मेशन। नाउ फॉर्मेशन मीन्स क्रिएशन, फॉर्म्स, इट इज जनरेटिंग। एंथैल्पी इज जनरेटिंग, एंथैल्पी इज इंक्रीजिंग, और एंथैल्पी वी कैन सी एंथैल्पी इज चेंजिंग और जनरेटिंग द एंथैल्पी। फॉर्मेशन मीन्स जनरेटिंग, क्रिएटिंग। ओके, एंड एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन इज रिटन एज डेल्टा एच एफ। एफ स्टैंड्स फॉर फॉर्मेशन एंड डेल्टा एच इज चेंज इन एंथैल्पी। हीट ऑफ फॉर्मेशन, एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज हीट ऑफ फॉर्मेशन बिकॉज एंथैल्पी इज अ हीट ऑफ फॉर्मेशन। हीट ऑफ फॉर्मेशन और एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन आर यूज टू प्रोवाइड अ कॉन्साइज कलेक्शन ऑफ थर्मोकेमिकल डाटा। फॉर कंसिस्टेंसी एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन डाटा आर रिकॉर्डेड फॉर रिएक्शन दैट टेक्स प्लेस अंडर स्टैंडर्ड कंडीशन। नाउ अंडर स्टैंडर्ड कंडीशन मीन्स अंडर स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट। स्टैंडर्ड कंडीशन आर कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर ऑफ 1 atmosphere। वी हैव सीन द स्टैंडर्ड स्टेट मीन्स स्टैंडर्ड प्रेशर ऑफ 1 atmosphere एंड फिक्स टेम्परेचर ऑफ 25 degree Celsius मीन्स दैट ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन टेक्स प्लेस एट 1 atmosphere एंड 25 degree Celsius। द एंथैल्पी चेंज व्हेन 1 mole ऑफ कंपाउंड इज फॉर्म्ड। द एंथैल्पी चेंज व्हेन 1 mole ऑफ कंपाउंड इज फॉर्म्ड फॉर इट्स कंस्टिट्यूएंट एलिमेंट एट 1 atmosphere एंड 25 degree Celsius इज कॉल्ड एज अ एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन। एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन इज डिफाइंड एज द एंथैल्पी चेंज व्हेन 1 mole ऑफ कंपाउंड इज फॉर्म्ड from its constituent elements. When 1 mole of compound is formed from its constituent element at 1 atmosphere and 25 degree Celsius, whatever change in enthalpy takes place is called as a enthalpy of formation. Suppose one CO2 is formed from its constituent element means from carbon and oxygen. When 1 mole of CO2, that is 1 CO2 is formed from its constituent elements means carbon and oxygen at 1 atmospheric pressure and 25 degree Celsius, then whatever enthalpy change, that enthalpy is called the enthalpy of formation. The element must be in their stable state at this pressure and temperature. Stable states means they does not change its state. Now look at here, nitrogen combines with hydrogen forms NH3, okay, ammonia. But here we want 1 mole, we are writing here when 1 mole of compound is formed, here compound is formed ammonia, that is NH3, we want 1 mole NH3. To form NH3 we required nitrogen gas and hydrogen gas, but nitrogen gas is available in the form of molecule, that is N2, and hydrogen is also available in the form of molecule, that is H2. Here N2 is available, but we want only 1 N, therefore we will take half of N2, we will take half of N2 means only N. We want H3. Here H2 is available. If we take 2H2, then it will be a 4, but we want H3, therefore it will be 3/2 H2. Now we have, whenever we write enthalpy of formation, we have to write its phase also at standard condition. At atmospheric condition means at 1 atmosphere and 25 degree Celsius, what is the state of that material? Nitrogen is available in the form of gas, therefore we are writing G in suffix. Hydrogen is also available in the form of gas. Naturally, hydrogen is available in the form of gas, therefore we are writing G in suffix. NH3, that is ammonia, is also a gas at atmospheric condition, therefore we are writing G. Suppose we take example of CO2, formation of CO2, that is CO2 will be formed from carbon and oxygen, but carbon is available in the form of solid. Carbon is available in the form of solid. In that, graphite is a stable state of a carbon. Graphite is a stable state of carbon. Therefore, we'll write CS, that is S stands for solid, and O, G. G stands for O2. G stands for gas, and we'll get CO2, and CO2 will be the gas. We'll take some example. Oxygen is available in the form of gas. Water is available in the form of liquid at atmospheric condition. Okay, when liquid is changed from liquid to vapor, then it changes its enthalpy, and such change in enthalpy is called as enthalpy formation or formation of enthalpy. Now formation of enthalpy of any substance at its standard state is always zero. Okay, carbon monoxide, CO, is a gas. Carbon dioxide, CO2, is a gas. Now this column gives the enthalpy of formation, and most of the cases enthalpy of formation is in negative. Now look at here, oxygen O is a gas, but oxygen is available in the form of O2 naturally. Oxygen is available in the form of molecule O2, and at atmospheric condition O2 is a gas, therefore O2 formation of enthalpy is zero. Formation of enthalpy is always zero, means at standard state and its standard physical state. Standard state means standard atmospheric condition, that is 1 atmospheric pressure and 25 degree Celsius. At a standard state, at a standard phase, means for oxygen it is a gas phase, change in enthalpy or enthalpy formation is always zero. Now carbon, C. Carbon can be a gas, diamond, graphite, but naturally available carbon is a graphite. Naturally available carbon is a graphite. When the carbon is found naturally, is a graphite, or we can say graphite is a most stable state of the carbon. Graphite is a most stable state of carbon. Therefore, carbon at its natural state, the formation of enthalpy of carbon at its natural state, which graphite state, is zero. बट डायमंड डायमंड डजेंट अकर नेचुरली. कार्बन कन्वर्ट इंटू डायमंड व्हेन इट हैज बीन प्रेशराइज एट वेरी हाई प्रेशर, देन इट बिकम्स डायमंड. ओके, अगेन कार्बन मोनोक्साइड CO, इट इज नॉट अ नेचुरली अवेलेबल, देन CO2 इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ नेचुरली अवेलेबल, इट इज फॉर्म्ड, देयर फॉर इट हैज एंथैल्पी ऑफ फॉर्मेशन. इफ यू टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नाइट्रोजन गैस, दैट इज N2, N2 इज अवेलेबल, देयर फॉर N2 इज अवेलेबल नेचुरली, दैट इज नाइट्रोजन इज अवेलेबल इन द फॉर्म ऑफ N2. Therefore, formation of enthalpy delta H for N2 is 0. If we take an example of hydrogen, that is H2, hydrogen is available in the form of gas naturally. Therefore, for hydrogen gas, formation of enthalpy is 0. But if we take an example of hydrogen liquid does not obtain naturally. Therefore, formation of enthalpy will not be 0 for liquid hydrogen. Again, for liquid nitrogen, formation of enthalpy of formation will not be 0. Again, for liquid oxygen, enthalpy of formation will not be 0. The enthalpy of formation will be 0 when the substance is available in its standard state at standard condition, standard phase. Now, calorific value or heating value of the fuel. Now, calorific value or heating value of the fuel means how much amount of heat is liberated when a unit mass of fuel is burnt. When unit mass of fuel is burnt, the energy liberated by the fuel when one unit of fuel is burnt, that heat energy is called as a calorific value or heating value. The calorific value or heating value of the fuel is defined as the energy liberated by the complete oxidation of one unit mass or volume of a fuel. The energy liberated by complete oxidation means complete combustion of one unit mass or one unit volume of fuel. It is expressed in kilojoule per kg for solid and liquid, and kilojoule per meter cube for gas. When we consider the gaseous fuel, we take one unit volume. When we consider solid or liquid fuel, then we consider one unit mass. It may be 1 gram, 1 kg, like that. If a fuel contains hydrogen, water will be formed as one of the product of combustion. If the fuel contains, like petrochemicals, it is a hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means contains carbon as well as hydrogen. When such fuel is burnt, hydrogen convert into water vapor or the water. If the water is condensed, the large amount of heat will be released than if the water exists in the vapor state. If the hydrocarbon is burnt, carbon convert into carbon dioxide or carbon monoxide depending upon the depending upon whether the combustion is complete or not, or whether the sufficient amount of oxygen is available or not. But hydrogen convert into water vapor. Okay, if that water vapor is condensed, that water vapor release the latent heat. Water vapor release the latent heat. For this reason, two heating values are defined. For this reason, two heating values are defined. Okay. The higher or the gross heating value and the lower or the net heating value. Higher heating value is also called as gross heating value, and lower heating value is also called as net heating value. The higher heating value, HHV, is obtained when the water formed by the combustion is completely condensed. Why it is called as higher heating value? Because when fuel gives some heat, when the fuel is burnt, it gives some energy. But water, when the hydrogen convert into water vapor, hydrogen convert into steam, and when that steam or the water vapor is condensed, it releases the latent heat, and that heat that heat is added in the higher heating value, that heat is added in the energy released by the combustion of fuel. Therefore, it is add on in the energy released by the fuel. Therefore, it gives the higher value than the energy released by the fuel. Therefore, it is called as a higher heating value. The lower heating value LHV is obtained when water formed by the combustion exists completely in the vapor phase. It means when the fuel burnt, it gives some energy, and hydrogen convert into water during the combustion does not condense. The water vapor formed during the combustion does not condense and it doesn't release the latent heat. Therefore, the heating value is remain as it is, as that the energy got in the got during the combustion. Therefore, that value is called as a lower heating value. Thus, the heating higher heating value of product, higher heating value of product is equal to lower heating value of product plus mass into change in mass into latent heat, mass of water vapor formed multiply by its latent heat. Now the lower heating value of is equal to lower heating value plus mass of water vapor and change in internal energy, change in internal energy, that is internal energy of the gas minus internal energy of the liquid, where mass is a mass of water formed by the combustion, where m is a mass of water formed by the combustion. HFG is the enthalpy of evaporation, or we can say latent heat of water in kilojoule per kg. U is the specific internal energy of vapor in kilojoule per kg, and UF is the specific internal energy of liquid, liquid water in kilojoule per kg. In most in almost all practical cases, the water vapor in the product is vapor. The lower value is one of which usually applies. In most of the combustion, the hydrogen which has been converted into water vapor doesn't condense, and the heating value remains the lower heating value, and which is the applicable in most of the cases. Determination of calorific or heating value. Now, how to determine calorific or heating value for solid and liquid fuel? We use the Dulong's formula. Dulong suggested a formula for calculation of calorific value of the solid and liquid fuels from their chemical composition, which is given below. Higher heating value is written as 1 by 100 into bracket 33800 into carbon plus 144000 in bracket H minus 0 by H minus O by S plus 9270S. Now C is the mass of carbon, H is the mass of hydrogen, O is the mass of oxygen, S is the mass of sulfur, and again S is the mass of sulfur. This is a gross calorific value, or we can say higher calorific value, where C, H, O and S are the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur in percentage respectively in 100 kg of fuel. In percentage respectively in 100 kg of fuel. In the above formula, the oxygen is assumed to be in the combination of hydrogen, and only extra sulfur hydrogen supplies the necessary heat. Now in this formula, carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur will be put in percentage if the 100 kg of fuel is used. Suppose 100 kg of fuel is used, and the mass, whatever the mass of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and sulfur will be present, will write that. But instead of 100, some different amount of fuel is taken, then we have to take in the percentage. Okay, now the here oxygen, whatever oxygen is available, the it will be considered the it is in the combination of hydrogen, and only extra sulfur hydrogen supplies the necessary heat. Determination of calorific value or heating value of a solid and liquid fuels using bomb calorimeter. Determination of calorific और हीटिंग वैल्यू ऑफ सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड फिल्स यूजिंग बॉम कैलोरीमीटर। दिस इज अ बॉम कैलोरीमीटर। बॉम कैलोरीमीटर कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ आउटर इंसुलेटेड बॉडी। आउटर इंसुलेटेड बॉडी इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज इंसुलेटेड जैकेट। इट इज जनरली मेडअप ऑफ अ वुडन बॉडी। इट इज जनरली मेडअप ऑफ वुड। इनसाइड दैट वुडन जैकेट, इनसाइड दैट इंसुलेटेड जैकेट, अ ग्लास बकेट और ग्लास बीकर इज यूज। ग्लास बीकर इज यूज एंड दिस ग्लास बीकर इज कंप्लीटली फिल्ड विथ वाटर। ग्लास बीकर इज कंप्लीटली फिल्ड विथ वाटर। इनसाइड अ ग्लास बकेट देर इज अ बॉम कैलोरीमीटर। दिस इज अ बॉम कैलोरीमीटर। ओके एंड दिस इज अ मेडअप ऑफ स्टील। दिस इज अ मेडअप ऑफ स्टील। नाउ इनसाइड विच देर इज अ वन क्रूसिबल एंड इनसाइड द क्रूसिबल देर इज अ फेल। द फेल विच इज टू बी बर्न्ट। नाउ फेल इज बर्न्ट विद द हेल्प ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक सप्लाई। द फेल इज बर्न्ट विद द हेल्प ऑफ इग्निशन कॉइल। नाउ दिस बॉम कैलोरीमीटर इज मेडअप ऑफ स्टील मेटल। दिस बॉम कैलोरीमीटर इज मेडअप ऑफ स्टील मेटल। इनसाइड बॉम कैलोरीमीटर देर इज अ क्रूसिबल एंड इन क्रूसिबल द फेल विच इज टू बी चेक्ड और द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ फेल टू बी डिटरमाइंड इज केप्ट। नाउ इन द फेल, फेल इज इन अ कॉन्टैक्ट विथ अ इलेक्ट्रिक कॉइल, दैट इज इग्निशन कॉइल एंड इग्निशन एंड द पावर इज सप्लाइड बाय द 6 वोल्ट बैटरी। पावर इज सप्लाइड बाय द 6 वोल्ट बैटरी। वेन द पावर इज सप्लाइड द कॉइल स्टार्ट हीटिंग एंड इट बर्न्स द फेल विच इज अवेलेबल इन द क्रूसिबल। वेन द फेल इज बर्न्ट इट प्रोड्यूसेज द हीट एट वेरी हाई प्रेशर एंड साउंड कम साउंड वेन द फेल बर्न्स साउंड कम्स लाइक अ बॉम्ब। देयरफॉर दिस कैलोरीमीटर इज कॉल्ड एज अ बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर। इट प्रोड्यूसेस, इट गिव्स अ साउंड लाइक अ बॉम्ब। देयरफॉर दिस कैलोरीमीटर इज कॉल्ड एज अ बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर। नाउ वेन द फेल इज बर्न्ट इट रिलीज द हीट। वेन फेल इज बर्न्ट इट रिलीज द हीट एंड स्टील बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर गेट हीटेड। स्टील बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर गेट हीटेड। नाउ हाउ टू मेजर हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ हीट इज रिलीज, दैट इज हाउ मच अमाउंट ऑफ कैलोरीफिक, व्हाट इज द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ फेल। आउटसाइड दैट वी आर यूजिंग वाटर, मीन्स बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर इज कंप्लीटली सराउंडेड बाय द वाटर। वेन द फेल इज बर्न्ट इट रिलीजेज द हीट। द बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर गॉट हीटेड, द स्टील पोर्शन, द स्टील बॉम्ब गॉट हीटेड एंड इट रिलीज द हीट, इट रिजेक्ट द हीट टू द वॉटर एंड वॉटर टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस। वॉटर टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस। वेन द फेल इज नॉट नॉट बर्न इनिशियली द टेम्परेचर विल बी रिकॉर्डेड बाय द थर्मोमीटर। द टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर विल बी रिकॉर्डेड बाय द थर्मोमीटर। वेन द फेल इज बर्न्ट एंड वॉटर विल गेट हीटेड, देन फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ द वॉटर विल ऑल्सो रिकॉर्डेड। इट विल गिव द चेंज इन टेम्परेचर। हियर वन स्टरर इज यूज, स्टरर इज यूज टू मेंटेन यूनिफॉर्म टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू आउट। स्टरर इज यूज टू मेंटेन यूनिफॉर्म टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू आउट। नाउ फॉर द कंबशन, कंबशन टेक्स प्लेस इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन ओनली। कंबशन टेक्स प्लेस इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन ओनली। देयरफॉर हियर वी यूज ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई वॉल। दिस इज द ऑक्सीजन सप्लाई वॉल। ऑक्सीजन इज सप्लाइड इन द बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर सो दैट कंबशन टेक्स प्लेस। हियर थर्मोमीटर इज यूज टू रिकॉर्ड इनिशियल एंड फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर। इनिशियल एंड फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ, इनिशियल टेम्परेचर मीन्स द टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर वेन द फेल इज नॉट कंबस्टेड एंड द फाइनल टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर मीन्स आफ्टर द कंबशन टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर इंक्रीजेस एंड दैट टेम्परेचर इज द फाइनल टेम्परेचर। स्टरर इज यूज टू मेंटेन यूनिफॉर्म टेम्परेचर ऑफ वॉटर थ्रू आउट। नाउ हियर मैग्नीफाइंग आईपीसी इज गिवन डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द टाइप ऑफ थर्मोमीटर। वी कैन चेक द रीडिंग बाय मैग्नीफाइंग आईपीस। नाउ एयर स्पेस बिटवीन द वुडन जैकेट एंड द ग्लास बीकर देर इज अ एयर स्पेस, देर इज अ एयर स्पेस। द कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू ऑफ सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड फ्यूल इज डिटरमाइंड इन द लेबोरेटरी बाय बॉम कैलोरीमीटर। इट इज सो नेम्ड बिकॉज इट्स शेप रिसेम्बल दैट ऑफ अ बॉम्ब। इट इज वन ऑफ द रीजन वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज अ बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर। अनदर रीजन, वेन फ्यूल इज बम्प्ड इट गिव्स द साउंड लाइक बॉम्ब। फिगर शोज द स्केमेटिक स्केच ऑफ अ बॉम्ब कैलोरीमीटर। द कैलोरीमीटर इज मेड ऑफ ऑस्टेनिटिक स्टील विच प्रोवाइड्स कंसिडरेबल रेजिस्टेंस टू कोरोजन and enable it to withstand high pressure. The calorimeter is strong cylindrical bomb in which combustion occurs. In the calorimeter is a strong cylindrical bomb in which combustion occurs. The bomb has a two walls at the tip. Look at here. These two tips are attached to the 6-volt battery with a positive and negative. When the battery start, when the switch is on, the current supplies and coil guts get heated. Due to the current supply, fuel burns. One supplies oxygen to the bomb and other releases exhaust gas. A crucible in which a weighted quantity of fuel sample is burnt is arranged between the two electrodes as shown in the figure. The calorimeter is fitted with water jacket which surrounds the bomb. To reduce the losses due to radiation, calorimeter is further provided with a jacket of water and air. The stirrer for keeping the temperature of water uniform and the thermometer to measure the temperature up to an accuracy of 0.001 degree Celsius are fitted through the lid of calorimeter. Now procedure. To start with, 1 gram of fuel sample is accurately weighted in the crucible. In a crucible, 1 gram of fuel is taken and the fuse wire whose weight is known is stretched between the electrode. It should be ensured that wire is in close contact with the fuel. Means the fuel should be in the close contact with the electric wires. To absorb the combustion product of sulfur and nitrogen, 2 ml of water is poured in the bomb. Bomb is then supplied with pure oxygen through the wall to an amount of 25 atmosphere. A bomb is then placed in the weighted quantity of water in the calorimeter. The stirrer is started after making the necessary electrical connection, and when the thermometer indicates the steady temperature, fuel is fired and temperature reading are recorded after half minute interval until the maximum temperature is attained. The bomb is then removed. The pressure slowly released through the exhaust valve and the content of the bomb are carefully weighted for further analysis. The heat released by the fuel of combustion is absorbed by the surrounding water. Okay, it means heat loss by steel is equal to heat gained by water. Therefore, we have to take a balance equation. From the above data, the calorific value of the fuel can be found from the following way. Let's consider WF is the weight of fuel sample in kg. WW is the weight of water. C is the calorific value, that is higher calorific value of fuel. W is the water equivalent of calorimeter. Now T1 is the initial temperature of water and calorimeter. T2 is the final temperature of water and calorimeter. Tc is the radiation correction. Tc is the temperature radiation correction, because we cannot measure the exact quantity of radiation happens during the combustion. Therefore, we take radiation correction. Now, C is the specific heat of water. Therefore, the heat released by the fuel, heat released by the fuel is mass of fuel into calorific value of fuel. Wf is the mass of fuel and C is the calorific value of fuel. During combustion, suppose mass is 1 kg and calorific value is 1000, then 1 into 1000, 1000 kilojoule per kg of heat will be generated. But in this case, we have to calculate calorific value. We don't know the value of C. We know the value of Wf. We know the mass of fuel. Now, the heat received by the water and calorimeter. The heat supplied by calorimeter to the water is Ww plus We into C, or we can say M C delta T. M is the mass of water plus, look at here, W is the mass of water and W is the equivalent mass. W is the water equivalent of calorimeter. Therefore, we have to consider both. Water equivalent of calorimeter. Here, WW is the weight of calorimeter and here WE is a water equivalent of calorimeter. Therefore, you have to consider WE also. Now, T2 is the final, C is the specific heat of water. T2 is the final temperature after combustion and T1 is the initial temperature before combustion and TC is the temperature correction, radiation temperature correction. Therefore, heat lost is equal to heat gain. Heat lost by the bomb calorimeter is equal to heat gain by the water. Now, heat lost by the calorimeter is equal to Wf into C and heat gain is equal to WW plus We C T2 minus T1 plus TC. In this case, everything is known to us. Only C is unknown. Therefore, we can calculate C. Capital C is a calorific value with the help of this expression. Now, value of C. C is a specific heat of water. Is 4.187 or 4.18 we can take in SI unit and unit in MKS unit.